Four export cables have been installed at Gwynt y Mor offshore wind farm, using the Cable Enterprise barge owned by Prysmian Powerlink Services. It's been a regular visitor to the North Wales coast, carrying the 132 kilovolt cables, which will transport the electricity generated by the 160 wind turbines from the two offshore substations to shore at Pensarn. From there, the electricity will be carried via an 11-kilometre underground cable route to a new substation at St Asaph and into the national grid. For each of the four visits to Pensarn Beach, a plough is lowered into the water in preparation for the cable burial out to sea.
The vessel approaches the beach and it sits at about the 5 metre contour, and it waits then and assesses the weather, looking for a clear window so that it can run into the beach, land on the beach and ground itself out in the shallow water. So they come in on the high water, and as the tide goes out, we then relax the vessel and sit down on the beach.
Subsea export cable landfall contractors GPC Cumbria await the arrival of the Cable Enterprise and work during low tide to pull the cable up the beach, through the ducts under the railway line and sea wall, and into the onshore transition pits. There's usually a 4 to 6 hour window in which to work.
It's gone in very, very well. And we've completed the pulling in one complete operation. But the guys are now tidying up and finishing off, so we wait for the next best low water so that we can get the maximum access to bury the cable and to get the cable buried all the way up the beach.
With all four cables installed, the beach is returned to its original state and no evidence of the cables will be visible. Meanwhile, the Cable Enterprise moves slowly away from the beach, burying the cable for approximately 19 kilometres to one of the two offshore substations.
You're actually seeing the cable come from the carousel. It will come all the way down the highway, over the stern of the vessel, and through the plough. It then transitions out of the plough into the seabed, giving full burial and protection of the cable.
The cable is made up of three conductors, three power cores, and a fibre optic bundle. During burial, every moment is closely monitored.
We have various survey equipment on board. We know where the plough is at any given moment, and this tells us if we're within our target burial depth and if we are within our target box. You'll see here the red line, which represents where the plough should travel. Once the plough moves along, following this red line, it remains within this corridor. This corridor is 10 metres wide.
Once at the offshore substation, a terminations team is waiting to receive the cable.
The cable sat on the back of the installation barge, the Cable Enterprise, and it has a set of rigging on their pennants with master links. We attach a line to the master link, which is called the pulling wire. Between the master link and the pulling wire, we have what's called a messenger. It's just a long piece of rope, basically, which attaches the two. They pull in until they bring our pulling wire onto the vessel, which then they'll attach to the end of the cable. First thing that will come through the top of the J2 with the master link, that master link attached to the two pennants, that's your first sign that the cable protection system is ready to engage. So it's an indicator that you know that you're nearly there, and then the rest of the cable, once that's detached, will be brought over from the top of the quadrant and just fed around. We have an overpull of approximately 20 metres. The termination team basically use the excess cable for the terminations above us. Once we have the 20 metres on deck, it's clamped off in a position at the top of the J-tube. A temporary clamp gets fixed and then made more permanent once we know that that's the final position. The cable protection system seals the bottom of the J-tube so nothing can get in or out.
With export cable installation complete, another major milestone has been achieved in the construction of Gwynt y Mor.